So let's proceed further in the lesson. Now, early next morning, Sadiq set to work with his father. He helped him clean the dal, make ghee, grind turmeric, peel and chop the onions, garlic and ginger. Okay, so next morning, of course, they had to prepare the dal. Okay, that was the final day. So now Sadiq helped his father in everything. Okay, grinding. Grind means to make powder of something. And then chopping. Chopping means cutting the vegetables, cleaning every possible thing, right? So then he watched Kadir cook the dal. Then he saw the process also of making dal. With the dal, Kadir made a light cucumber raita, a mint chutney, a vegetable dish of cauliflower and potatoes, a plate of creamy and soft kebabs. Alright, so all these things Kadir prepared along with the dal, okay, to make it a perfect lunch for the Nawab. Alright, so and once the Nawab sat down to eat, he would serve freshly baked tandoori rotis. Okay, so this was the plan, that after, I mean, when the Nawab has already sat there, after that he would be served with rotis. For dessert, there what dessert is, the sweet serving which we have generally after the main meals, right? There were bowls of firni, so that is a dessert, alright, which is made with milk. Sadiq had sneaked a quick taste of the dal when his father wasn't looking. It tasted utterly delicious, okay? It was the secret masala that made all the difference. Now, don't we do all this? I'm sure you all must have done this sometime in the kitchen when your mother cooks something very tasty, delicious, and you just take something out of that and you just taste it, right? So the expression sneaked a quick taste, it means to secretly take a part of something being cooked and just taste it, okay? So, and when he tasted it was utterly delicious, means very tasty, okay? So it was the secret masala, of course. Now, everything was ready. The dal in the handi was bubbling. Bubbling gently. Bubbling means when it is boiling, okay? So it forms some bubbles over the surface, right? Over the top. Now, gently on the angiti, balls of dough, moist and ready to be slapped into rotis. Now, balls of dough. Dough means from which we prepare the rotis. So balls were already prepared and they were moist with ghee, right? So everything was ready. The raita cooling in an earthen bowl, okay? Earthen bowl which are made of sand and mud. So the raita was there inside so that it gets cool, right? Kadir turned to his son. Go, call the Nawab. I'm ready to serve lunch. Now everything was ready. So Kadir asked Sadiq to call for the Nawab. Now Sadiq ran all the way to Nawab Hasan Ali's Haveli. He reached the Nawab hopes, panting. Alright, when you run or when you exercise for some time, so you just lose breath and that is called panting, okay? Now, I've come to call Nawab Saab for lunch. The dal is ready, he said to the servant, okay? Go up the roof. Nawab Saab is flying kite there, okay? So he reached there and he told the servant about the purpose that he went there. And then he got to know that the Nawab is on the roof and he is flying the kites. Sadiq ran up the stairs to the roof. The Nawab and his friends were completely engrossed. completely engrossed means when you are lost in something. When you are not aware what's happening around me, you are just lost in whatever you are doing. That is called engrossed. Okay. So the Nawab and his friends, they were engrossed in flying kites. Sadiq went up to Hasan Ali and said timidly, "Nawab sir, the dal is ready. My father is calling you." Okay. So now he sat there. And he went there and said timidly. Timidly means not very confidently. Okay, he was, because he knew he was talking to Nawab, and he, being a child, of course he was a little timid. So very politely he told the Nawab. Hasan Ali looked down at Sadiq, who then he seemed to remember. Ah, yes, the dal. Okay. One of my friends, one of his friends laughed. "Forget the dal, Hasan. Your kite is in danger. The green kite is about to cut it." Okay. So the Nawab, he remembered that, yes, the dal and about the lunch. But one of his friends said, "Oh, forget about the dal. Forget it. See, your kite is in danger. Why don't you focus on that? Forget the dal." Right? Hasan Ali hurriedly pulled at the kite, at his kite. "Just you wait, green kite, I'll get you," he shouted. So again, hurriedly means with speed, speedily. So again, he got lost into the kite and his kite flying. Okay. Nawab sahab, Sadiq interrupted. Interrupt means to stop someone when somebody is doing something, to disturb someone in the middle of something. Okay, so he again interrupted, worried about his father's temper. "The food is waiting." Okay. "Yes, yes," Hasan Ali said, irritated. Irritated is when you just start to lose the temper. Okay, irritated. "Tell your father to wait. Can't you see my flight is in danger?" "Yes." "Run along, boy," one of his friends said impatiently. "Can't you see Nawab sahab is busy?" Okay, so one of the Nawab's friend, he just, you know, shoo the boy away, that please go away from here. What are you doing here? Can't you see he is busy? So please go away from here. But the dal, Sadiq gave up and sadly walked away. All his dreams were fading away. Fade away is a phrasal verb, beta. And fade away means when something was there and now it's, you know, disappearing slowly, fading away. So that's a phrasal verb. All right. So, but the dal, yes, all his dreams were fading away. He knew what would happen. He knew his Abu's temper. The moment Qadir heard that the Nawab preferred to fly kites to tasting his dal, he would fly into a rage and give the handi of dal to the first beggar. They could forget about the reward. Sadiq felt like crying now. Whatever happened at the Nawab's Haveli, now Sadiq was coming back from there and he was really sad, because he knew now our dreams, they are just, they are not going to be a real story now, right? Because he knew that his father would get very angry when he would get to know that he preferred to fly kites over having the dal. Right? And he would just give it to any beggar now. Alright? So he was very terrified now. And what about the reward? Obviously, all the dreams that Sadiq had, seen. Now, on reaching home, he looked up. The Nawab's kite was flying overhead. And his friend Aman was flying a kite from his rooftop across the lane. Now when he reached home, he saw that the Nawab was still flying the kite, because he could see the flight. and then instantly he saw his friend Aman was also flying kite there on the rooftop. Now suddenly a wonderful idea struck Sadik. He ran to Aman's rooftop. Aman, do me a favor. See that blue and silver kite. Cut it fast. Okay? Now he got an idea and he just ran to Aman and he requested him to cut Nawab's kite. Okay? Alright. Now, sure, no problem, said Aman, grinning. Grinning means smiling. Okay? Grin means to smile. He was a champion kite flyer. Okay, so it was very easy for him. He made a special kite with a string with a layer of ground glass that could cut through anything. So he made a special kite very fast and he was champion in that. Sadik raced back to the Nawab's house. He ran up the stairs and reached the roof just as Aman had positioned his kite directly above the Nawab's. Aman gave a sharp tug. Oh no! Hasan Ali groaned in dismay as his kite was cut and wafted down towards the ground. And as they planned, they did the same. Okay? They just cut the Nawab's kite and it just groaned. Wafted means when something is cut and it just floats down on the ground like this. Okay? Wafted means when something cuts and floats downwards. Alright? Wafted. Alright. Now come to the next page, 29. Huzur, Sadik said, the food is waiting. The dal is delicious. Oh yes, yes. The Nawab suddenly remembered the special dal. Now the kite's gone. Let's go and eat. Now Sadik, when the kite was cut, he just ran to the Nawab's Haveli again. And the moment it was cut, he, requested him again to come for the lunch. Then Nawab was free now. So he said, okay, now my kite is also cut now. All right, let's go for the dal for the lunch. Okay?